真。
Swan Wall Gates in the south and the Forbidden City in the north were linked in a unique way. According to Taoist belief, heaven is round and the earth is square, Tai Chi is the source of movement, and yin and yang interact. This worldview, which embodies a kind of simple dialectics, was the worldview through which ancient Chinese understood the world. The unique round lotus-shaped Rui gates of the Taoist temples of Mount Wudang and the square gates of the Forbidden City were designed based on this worldview to express the link between the two sites.
在云间飘下来，用这个鹤一样的这个视角来观看武当，这个时候呢，武当就会呈现出一个巨大的一个伟大的一个作品，而它的每一个建筑群的点都会成为这一个大的交响乐的每一个细小的乐章。
When the Chinese stringed instruments, the qin and the si, are played together, there's a wonderful harmony between them. Both draw our minds back to the ancient past. In the 18th year of the reign of Emperor Zhuge, when the Forbidden City was nearly finished and the Temple of Heaven and Temple of Earth had just been completed, the Office of Sacred Music was established. This imperial institution was responsible for training musicians and dancers and for preparing the sacred music to be performed in the Hall of Ceremonial Music in the Temple of Heaven. Xianyo Hall, also in the Temple of Heaven, was dedicated to Xuan. The emperor recruited Taoist musicians from all over the country, and he selected 400 of the finest for his musical troupe. When we listen to the sacred music of the Ming and Qing dynasties available to us today, we can't help but imagine what a performance of Ming dynasty imperial music must have sounded like. Everything had been done in preparation for the imminent completion of work. From the time he wrested power from his nephew, Zhuge Di had never had a moment's rest from service to his country. He'd raised an army to suppress the remnants of the Yuan dynasty in the north, and in the south, he'd dealt with Japanese pirates. Every night, alone and lonely, music like this would have soothed his heart like a gentle breeze. In the 19th year of his reign, all the major construction work on the Forbidden City was completed. No one could begin to comprehend the myriad of emotions the emperor felt when he looked upon the nearly finished palace, just as it was impossible to calculate the personal price he had paid to reach the pinnacle where he now stood. One night during the previous few months, when work on the Hall of Supreme Harmony, Hall of Central Harmony, and Hall of Preserving Harmony was being completed, Emperor Zhuge Di had a mystical experience that made him feel that he'd been struck by a bolt of lightning. Such was the intensity of this experience that, compared with it, all his work since taking the throne seemed like nothing. At this time, construction work on Mount Wudang was also nearing completion. Only the most difficult task remained, completing the Forbidden City within the confines of the Palace of Harmony on Mount Wudang. After his mystical experience, the question of whether or not it could be completed successfully became the emperor's greatest spiritual support.
当时呢，永乐皇帝下了70多道圣旨，讲究，七山分毫不能修动，所有的建筑群要依山就势，巧妙布局，若隐若现。现在大家看到的武当山的古建筑群，有的是在高山之巅，有的是在悬崖峭壁，啊，都是遵循了这个人与自然高度和谐这个规律，自然生态非常好，没有遭到人为的破坏。
On every important occasion, Master Wu holds a prayer service with his fellow Taoist monks to pray for the common people. One morning 600 years ago, when the purple gold city of Mount Wudang was nearly completed, the Taoist monks on the mountain busily and nervously prepared to play the incomparably powerful and moving Ming Dynasty imperial music.
武当的这个建筑呢，还有它的特色。它最精彩的就是所谓的紫禁城，北京嘛叫紫禁城啊，它是叫紫禁城。那个那一群建筑啊，那就是那个金顶啊，所谓的金顶，这个金殿也在上头，旁边用这个石头砌筑的高墙围绕的这个山顶，那也是非常的雄伟壮观的。
In the year 1424, a grand state ceremony of the Ming Dynasty took place in the center of the country at Mount Wudang. The purple gold city on the mountain's golden summit was finally completed, and during the recitation of prayers, it seemed as if the peak was suddenly bathed in heavenly light. From a distance, the sturdy building seemed to be perched on the peak precariously. The wall surrounding the summit has heavenly gates at the four cardinal points to symbolize the vastness of the heavens and the majesty of the spirit world. Mount Wudang has a unique landscape dominated by clusters of high peaks that stand over the surrounding countryside, commanding respect. These mountains also provide conquerors with a medium for expressing imperial power and carrying favor with the gods.
去北京的故宫，我们看的是文物，看的是建筑。但是登武当，更多你感觉的是山林，是一种云卷云舒之间那种自由浩荡。所以其实为什么人登山会觉得身心舒朗，有些境界不在攀援之中是不能体会到的。武当山是很雄奇的，云遮雾绕，在一路攀援而上的时候，其实你能够感觉到中国的武侠和中国的哲学，中国最宁静的这和那种无为无不为的那种思想。
The worship of the god Xuan Wu, which was begun by Emperor Zhu Di, continued through the reigns of the Qing emperors Kang Xi and Qianlong. Today, changes over time in the names of the principal halls along the axis of the Forbidden City give people an insight into the spiritual support that successive emperors drew from Wudang culture and Tai Chi culture. When the Forbidden City was built, Emperor Zhu Di named the largest hall the Hall of Offerings to Heaven. Ming Emperor Jia Jing renamed it the Hall of Imperial Supremacy, and it was given its present name, the Hall of Supreme Harmony, by Qing Emperor Xuanzhu. Harmony between heaven and earth was an ideal embraced by many emperors. In the year 1535, Emperor Jia Jing built the Heaven One Gate outside Qin'an Hall to make it more convenient for him to offer sacrifices. This gate corresponds to the Heaven One pool on Mount Wudang, and both derive their names from the occurrence of the term Heaven One in the ancient river diagram associated with the I Ching. The Ming Dynasty flourished for over 200 years, during which time emperors prayed to Mount Wudang each in his own way, so that the mountain and the god Xuan Wu would protect and bless their reign. By simply being there, they could feel the great awe people had for heaven and earth. In the year 1703, after a long period of silence, Emperor Kangxi inscribed the words "Wondrous Golden Light" in his own hand on a plaque placed on the Golden Palace at Mount Wudang. 30 years later, Emperor Qianlong inscribed the words "Grasp the Central Axis" in his own hand on a plaque placed in Qin'an Hall in the Forbidden City.
Yuan Shu, 就是天的中轴。他掌握着这个中轴，那么实际上呢，他就掌握着紫禁城的中轴。紫禁城的中轴啊，也就是全中国的中轴。天轴啊，在不断的旋转，所有的心呢，都啊绕着天在运转。那么真武大帝啊，就掌握着这个中轴，所以说啊，他的作用非常之大。那么这尊神的地位呢，已经呢尊到了至高无上的地位，他就成为紫禁城的保护神，也称为明清王朝的保护神。
highest meaning of the Chinese word he, which in modern Chinese means peace or harmony, was musical instrument. Music mediates between joy and sadness and between dreams and reality. It also fosters universal peace. For 600 years, this sacred mountain, a source of spiritual sustenance for Emperor Zhuge and all his successors, together with the Forbidden City in Beijing, the symbol of imperial power, the most mysterious places in all of China. It's almost as if you can hear the strains of heavenly music. Today, people are still using music to pour out their hearts to this mountain. For thousands of years, the rich and varied tableau of the mountain's landscape has both revealed and concealed the way of nature, and it's never ceased to respond to its human visitors.